let's see, I have to find the volume of this building and then compare that with this exchange rate for the air. So I can see that I have a rectangular prism as the base and a triangular prism on the roof. I have enough dimensions to find the volume of the base, but for this triangular part, I need to know the area of the base, which is this triangle, times its height, or this length, which I know is 100 feet. Let's take a look at this triangle. I know it's isosceles, and I know if I drop the height down to an isosceles, it'll be 90 degrees, and that cuts the base in half. So I've got 10 feet here, 90 degrees, 45 degrees. Don't have enough information here to find the height. Let's take a look at that triangle again. So if the base angles are both 45, then I know that top angle is 90, which means I can use this 90 degree triangle with this side being the base and this side being the height. So let's call both those sides S, and now using Pythagorean's theorem, I can find the value of S. So S squared plus S squared equals 20 squared. Combine the S squareds on the left, divide by 2. S equals the square root of 200. I can leave that as the square root of 200. I can reduce that radical to 10 root 2. This is my exact answer, and that's the way I want to leave it to find my exact volume. So now I'm ready to find the volume of this building. Let's recall it'll be the volume of the triangular prism on the top and the volume of the rectangular prism on the bottom added together. So there are my formulas that I'm going to use. Area of the base of this triangular prism, 10 root 2 times 10 root 2, half base times height, right there, times 100. And here I've substituted in the values I need for the rectangular prism. So my volume comes out to be 40,000 cubic feet. If I divide that by 600 cubic feet per minute, I can see that it's going to take much too long, way over 30 minutes, for this ventilation system to exchange all the air. So it's not adequate. To check, I could have done my solution a little differently. So to check, I could have just determined how much air is being exchanged in 30 minutes with this air exchanger. You can see 18,000 cubic feet is not anywhere near the volume of the building. Therefore, it's not an adequate system.